Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. Today I've got a very special Battle Royale netcode video for you, where you won't just learn a bit more about PUBG, Fortnite and H1Z1, formerly known as King of the Kill, you will also find out which of these currently provides the lowest network delay. Now, while I always do my best to keep the netcode analysis as simple as possible, you will still need to have some basic knowledge about computer networking, tick rates, update rates, network models, super bullets, lag compensation, packet loss, and a few other things like how I do my network delay tests. So to keep the netcode analysis videos as short as possible, I've put all this information into a separate netcode 101 video, which you should have watched at least once before you continue with this video here. The card overlay in the top right corner of this video, as well as the link in the description down below, will both take you directly to that video. So let's talk about PUBG, Fortnite and H1Z1. Both PUBG and Fortnite use the Unreal Engine 4 from Epic Games, which is also the development studio behind Fortnite. H1Z1 on the other hand uses the Forgelite engine, which has been developed for MMOs and very high player counts. It powers games like PlanetSide 2, Payday the Heist, DC Universe Online and EverQuest. When we talk about the player-to-player delay in an online multiplayer game, then we must also talk about the frame rate. PUBG has a FPS cap of 144 which the player can't remove, while Fortnite and H1Z1 do not cap the frame rate. If you want to limit your frame rate at a specific value so that you always have the same amount of input lag, or to keep the frame rate inside the G-Sync or FreeSync window of your monitor, then PUBG sadly does not provide you with a built-in FPS limiter. Fortnite has such a feature, but you can only choose between three presets. You can't set the custom FPS limit like you can in Overwatch. In H1Z1 you can enter a custom frame rate limit, but you have to edit a config file for that. Now let's get to the networking of these games. There have been rumors that PUBG would switch to Microsoft's cloud service Azure, and while it's possible that the game uses Azure on the Xbox, the PC version of PUBG always connects me to a server hosted by AWS. Also, I'm not aware of a statement from the developers where they announced that they will switch to Azure. If you have a link to such a statement from the developers, then please post the link in the description down below. Fortnite does not only use the same engine as PUBG, they also use AWS to host the game servers. In H1Z1 you will primarily end up on Daybreak's own servers, but should it become necessary then they can also utilize Amazon's cloud service AWS to spawn additional game server instances there. Now, in which regions do these games provide servers in? PUBG currently provides servers in more locations than Fortnite or H1Z1, however Epic Games announced that they will add servers in more locations earlier this year. Even though PUBG does seemingly have better server coverage than the other two games, it must be said that players would benefit from PUBG utilizing additional server providers like Azure, as that will increase server coverage. Another important point is that unlike PUBG or Fortnite, H1Z1 does not allow players to connect to a region to which they have a ping of more than 200 milliseconds. It does that to mitigate the negative impact that players with a lot of latency have on the experience of players who have a low ping to the game server. More on that a little bit later. Now, when it comes to the network delay, then the rates at which the game sends and receives data have a very strong impact on the player's experience. So I used Wireshark to capture my network traffic during multiple games so that I could then find out more about these two update rates. What I found was that in PUBG the minimum send rate of the server is 2 Hz, the average is 18 Hz and the maximum is 31 Hz. In Fortnite it's 7 Hz, 19 Hz and 30 Hz, and in H1Z1 it's 16, 76 and 148 Hz for the server's send rate. So what can we learn from this? When you just look at the average rates, then the H1Z1 server clearly has the highest send rate and so possibly also the highest tick rate, as the server has to generate that data. If you then compare Fortnite and PUBG, then you could think that Fortnite beats PUBG by 1 Hz. But while you're correct that Fortnite's server performance beats PUBG's, it's not because of that 1 Hz difference. To understand why Fortnite's servers perform better, we have to take a closer look at the network statistics to see the real difference. Here we have the send rate of the H1Z1 server, which stays well above 50 Hz most of the time. Then we've got the Fortnite server, which starts at around 8 Hz, then goes up to 10 Hz and steadily increases its send rate as the match progresses. There is not a single significant drop in the server's send rate. Now let's have a look at PUBG. Just like in Fortnite, the PUBG server also sends about 8 updates per second when the match starts and then increases its send rate as more and more players die. However, its send rate has significant drops throughout the entire match. And if you have a gunfight while such a drop occurs, then you will be affected by a lot more delay, which is one of the reasons why you might get shot around a wall. So generally speaking, the server performance increases when there are fewer players, which means that the server will send more updates per second, and that results in lower delays. However, in PUBG I also noticed that sometimes the server send rate would suddenly start to decrease later in the match, which also increased the network delay, and this is the case on both the old and the new map. So when we compare this to Fortnite, then not only does its server performance steadily increase as the match progresses, its send rate also does not suffer from these massive drops. You will also notice that despite an occasional spike, the Fortnite server peaks at a send rate of 20 Hz, as the developers limit it to that rate, while in PUBG they allow the server to run as fast as it can, which might even be why we see those send rate drops, as that could indicate a stall of the server. In the development blog, Epic Games said that their goal is to achieve a stable 20 Hz in Fortnite's Battle Royale mode, which means that the developers of the Unreal Engine have set 20 Hz as their goal. So with that in mind, it seems logical that the Unreal Engine is indeed a limiting factor here for both Fortnite and PUBG, as it simply wasn't developed for large player counts, unlike the Forgelight engine used by H1Z1. So I fear that the PUBG developers can't really do all that much about the low tick and update rates of the server, as it seems to be the engine that is holding them back. But they could surely do something about these drops, as these do not occur in Fortnite. Besides the send and tick rate of the server, the update rate of the client is also important. Here we can see that all three games use quite similar rates, but what is interesting is that the H1Z1 client sends fewer updates than it receives from the server, which is a bit unusual. Now, how can a player find out if the issue that he experiences in the game is a result of a problem with his internet connection, or maybe a performance problem of the server? PUBG does not provide the player with any kind of network information, while in Fortnite you can enable a network overlay which shows the ping to the game server, how much up and downstream bandwidth the game uses, and it even shows you the send rate of the server and the send rate of the client, as well as outbound and inbound packet loss. So Epic Games provides the player with very useful information here. However, I'm not quite sure if the ping here is actually the round trip time between my client and the server, as it is about half of what I get when I ping the AWS data center. And when I artificially increase my ping by 200 milliseconds, then this value here only increases by 100 milliseconds. So you have to take that ping value with a grain of salt. In H1Z1, you see the ping to the server in the top right corner, where the developers even use colors to tell you if your ping is good or bad. In addition to that, you can use the N key on your keyboard to enable the network overlay. Inside the overlay, you can then see how much bandwidth the game client uses. Ping 1 tells you the round trip time of UDP game data between the client and the match server, and you will notice that it is lower than the ping 2 value, as that also includes the time the match server needs to process a data packet. So should ping 2 be significantly higher than ping 1, then this could indicate a performance issue on the server. And lastly, the overlay shows you inbound and outbound packet loss. However, in my tests I noticed that these do not update very frequently, which is why they might not pick up occasional packet loss. I've made the developers aware of this, so hopefully they can increase the update rate of that value in the future. Now let's check out the results of my network delay tests, where I measured the delay between two players who had a ping of 25 milliseconds to the game server. To get conclusive results, I tested PUBG, Fortnite and H1Z1 5 times per day on 4 different days. I also made sure that I finished each test run during the first 5 minutes of the match, so that each game was tested when the server was under the most stress. So let's start with H1Z1, which provided very consistent results throughout all test runs. In the damage test, I measured an average delay of 42.75 milliseconds. In the gunfire test, I measured an average delay of 61 milliseconds. And in the movement test, I measured an average delay of 77.75 milliseconds. So the gunfire and animation delays are quite a bit longer than the damage delay, which we have seen in other games as well. However, I did reach out to the developers already, and maybe they can bring those delays down a bit in future updates. Then we've got Fortnite, which also showed very consistent results in all test runs, but it suffers from longer delays due to its lower update rates. The delays are even a bit worse than what I measured the last time. Then we've got PUBG. Sadly, the only consistent thing about its test results is that they are very inconsistent, which is not really a surprise when you remember that the server send rate is all over the place, no matter on which map you play. So the results that I will show you now are from a test run that represents the most common results that I got. It's not the best run, nor the worst. So at a ping of 25 milliseconds to the game server, players can expect an average damage delay of 173.3 milliseconds, an average gunfire delay of 172 milliseconds, and an average movement delay of 138 milliseconds. These are by far the worst results that I've measured in PUBG since I tested it for the very first time back in March 2017. So, while the developers managed to increase the frame rate on the client and added many very useful game mechanics, the network performance actually got worse. We have reached a point where you will see a network delay of more than 1 second while such a drop in the server's send rate occurs. So, as I've said before, the Unreal Engine is most likely a limiting factor here, as not even Epic Games can currently get Fortnite to run at 20Hz from the round start to the round end. But that does not change that the Fortnite servers run a lot smoother, neither does it change the fact that PUBG's network delay continues to get worse. The PUBG developers probably don't have a lot of options to get a long-term solution. They can either start to rework parts of the Unreal Engine on their own, or wait for Epic to make the engine fit for games which put more than 50 players on a server. But what we need right now from the PUBG developers is a short-term solution, where they fix those drops in the server's send rate and get the network delay down to the level of Fortnite. They might also want to consider to limit the server's tick and update rates to a value that it can maintain, like Epic currently caps the Fortnite server's send rate at 20Hz. I also hope that PUBG will eventually include a network overlay similar to what we have in Fortnite, and it would be great to get an unlocked frame rate, as well as a built-in FPS limiter where players can set a custom FPS limit like we can in Overwatch. Now, there are two more things that I would like to show you. First is how much traffic these games generate. As you can see here, PUBG, Fortnite and H1Z1 create surprisingly little traffic, but please keep in mind that this is not a rating nor a ranking. And what kind of netcode analysis would this be if we didn't check out some lag compensation examples? As I mentioned before, H1Z1 does not allow you to connect to a region when your ping to that region is higher than 200 milliseconds. However, should a player suffer from network congestion or buffer bloat, then this could increase his ping to more than 300 milliseconds at any point during the match. Should this happen, then the H1Z1 server will still confirm that hit, and so a player with a ping of 25 milliseconds to the server will receive that shot very far behind cover. In the description below, you can find a link to a video where I tell you more about buffer bloat and what you can do about it. Fortnite and PUBG, on the other hand, do not have a ping lock yet, which would prevent you from joining a region. But even if they had, the server would still confirm a hit even when the shooter has a ping of more than 200 milliseconds, as none of these games seem to have a limit for how much latency they compensate, which is one of the reasons why you will receive damage far behind cover. So I hope that this netcode analysis of PUBG, Fortnite and H1Z1 helps you to get a better understanding of what is going on in these games, which problems they have and what needs to change. I will keep an eye on the progress that the developers make and release update videos as changes become available. If you enjoy these netcode analysis videos, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon. Thanks to the awesome support of my patrons, I can continue to bring you this kind of content. So if you like my work, then you can find the link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you can also do a one-time donation. If you want to stay up to date on what I'm currently working on, then you can follow me on Twitter or Facebook, the links are in the description of this video. And if you don't want to miss the next one, then you might want to subscribe to my channel and click on the little bell icon below this video to receive a notification when I upload the next one. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris and this was Battle Nonsense.